In a little district, in a neighborhood, people move and swim like they think they should. A word from your mouth, your lights get knocked out. A glass to your lips, and later you move and slip. And if you have to, don't trip. I don't know how they manage, but believe me, mister, they do. If you ever live there, you just listen and don't be no fool. In a little district, in a neighborhood, people move in swift like they think they should. A word from your mouth, your lights get knocked out. A glass from your lip, later you move and trip. If you have to, just slip. No one ask no question, no one tell no lie. Listen to me, people, it's the reason why. A word from your mouth, your lights get knocked out. A glass from your lip, and later you move and trip.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Back to it.
Oh yeah.
Not a second too late.
It's been like a whole month, dude.
Yep.
Straight up full month.
Yeah, we had to take some time off.
Gathering. Hunting and gathering topics.
I was battling my life away to try to fucking exist. God damn. But now somewhat got the ducks in order.
Right.
Slightly. Fucking A. Took a whole month.
That's right. Yeah, my ducks are all fucked up right now.
Hey, fucking, yeah. It's because you run around the streets like a little fucking whore. That's why your ducks are all out of line, buddy.
Oh, Midnight Cowboy.
Sketch, you don't want to be that, bro.
Nah, for sure.
Have you seen that movie?
I've only seen the parts that, I walked in on.
Yeah, you probably missed the part where he sucks a guy's dick. Trying to claim Midnight Cowboy, your sketch.
That is sketch.
But there's, yeah,
that,
man.
There's that scene. I remember the scene where he's in the theater and the dude's trying to suck his dick. That's pretty burnt.
Yeah.
More of the delusion of grandeur that he had when he's when it's like the dream sequence. Like they get the hotel popping off and they're just like making a shitload of money and they're all like fucking dressed up.
Oh yeah. That was in New York City.
It's that delusion. I guess I carry that more.
Sketch, bruh.
No, I just try to stay busy, playing beats and drawing and shit.
Feel you on that.
Yeah, just staying busy, dude.
Busy buddy.
Busy body.
It's crazy is how busy we all stay. You never really end up getting your fucking ducks in order. Shit crazy.
Right, you're always like, oh, I'm about to fucking clean this duck up, put him in line, and then you just never really get around to it until like 2 years later.
Yeah. Straight the fuck up. That's pretty much what happened to the podcast in the past month.
It's an oily duck, dude.
It's an oily little duck.
Poor little Don duck.
She.
Oil spill, dude. We caused the oil spill, too.
I caused the oil spill this morning out of my butt, dude.
Okay. Dude. That's a good one, though, dude. That kind of gets you ready for the day. More so than not having one.
Yeah, for sure.
More so than just sitting on the toilet waiting for something to come out.
If I fucking have a chance to shit in the morning, I get, like, cocky afterwards. Like, so ready to go.
Huh, you're just like, know that seize I'm, anything.
Yeah, at least I'm not going to get caught by a fucking vicious shit.
Huh.
Knowing that'll give you some confidence.
Yeah, you've just been blocked for a whole day, and then you're like, all right, this morning.
Yeah, if you end up missing a day, that day after is like gamble, bro.
Dude.
Every move you make is a risk.
Yeah. Don't want to like stretch too much, because you, you might pull something that's going to pull that.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. You
sip a little sparkling water, and it just jars something loose real quick, and you're like, oh, shit. Wait a minute.
Gotta go.
I'm miles away from home.
Huh. Then you just have to pray that the local bathroom is fucking clean enough to do your work.
Oh, you travel all that way to the local public restroom, and then you hit that handle, it's just locked, and you're just like, your stomach just gurgles.
Dude, you have to wait, and then you feel all sus, like, kind of, like, just, you're kind of in line. Jeez. In your head, you're in line, so you're like, you don't want to stand right next to the bathroom, so you just, I sit.
Yeah, exactly. You try to act casual.
Yeah, try to be casual.
Get a little water cup.
Just dart straight there.
You always walk, like, real slow, and then as soon as that door closes, you just fucking, turn into demon.
The nutty one is, like, after the work, and then the person coming in, like, immediately after just has to smell the remnants.
Yeah. I don't feel bad about that. I'm just like, whatever, bro.
I kind of feel bad.
Nah, homie. You're in the jungle, bro.
That's true.
Come on, dude.
That's true. Concrete jungle, dude. Fucking concrete.
They should keep, like, fucking small compost piles in most, like, major areas so that if you have to shit, you just dig a hole real quick and fucking drop deuce in a 3-foot hole.
Just designated shitting areas or just, like,
yeah,
like on the curb, like a sidewalk, a little planter area? Just drop deuce.
Preferably, like, off to the side.
Yeah. Because I wouldn't want to be walking down the street and then just see some...
It's
some
like an in case shit. Of emergency thing, not like, oh, hell yeah. Like, it's like, if it's just if all else fails.
All else fails, yeah. It's like late at night, like everything's closed.
There damn near might be a guard at the spot, like, checking your paperwork, making sure you only hit that shit, like, once in the
once
past...
Once a week, yeah.
That would be good for us.
Right, we'd need that. And then we'd have beautiful plants growing.
Yeah.
With our own feces. It's a community effort, bro.
Yeah.
Community efforts, bro.
Hell yeah, man.
Working on that shit every day, man. Every fucking day, dude.
Smoking on that shit.
Huh. Smoking that shit.
You were smoking on some shit.
When I was in Mexico, I smoked on that shit.
Your sketch.
By accident.
Sketch. For real.
It wasn't intentional.
You smoked some laced shit?
Yeah.
What the hell?
Yeah, it was like 3 months in, no smoking bud, chain smoking cigs and
Mexican cigs,
filterless cigs.
Uy.
And the Fadros. And I met this cat who for sure smoked weed. I was like, oh, like, let's blaze it after school one day. And he said he was down. We kept blazing it for like 3 or 4 times, and then it was like 5th or 6th time they laced it, and I couldn't tell till I left the car.
What the hell? What did they lace it with?
Crack.
Are you sure?
Yeah, they told me. I asked them. I was like, what the fuck did y'all lace that shit with? And that was like the day after in the morning. I was like still in shambles, bro.
Bro, what the hell? What'd
he
say?
I was still all fucked up.
He was like, that's right.
Well, like, he was with this other dude that was also in our class. And they were kind of looking at me all crazy, like I was going to rat on them. But I was like, full, like, I'm not going to rat on y'all.
Yeah, you're mostly just pissed.
I'm just pissed.
They're probably not used to fools being bummed that it was crack. Like, he was probably like, what the fuck?
They're like, we just do that here, dog. Yeah. They literally just told me, like, we just do that. But, bro, part of the experience was so fucked up. So I get in the car, and it's just, like, midday. And then by the time I'm leaving the car, the sun's setting. So, like, 3 or 4 hours pass.
Gnar.
And I felt like I'd just been smoking, like, 3 or 4 rips.
Whoa.
Yeah. Out of a steamer. And the steamer could have been, like, I guess, used for more crack.
That's gnarly, bro.
Has, like, other remnants of shit.
So, you're in the car for 4 hours and it felt like 3 rips?
Yeah.
What the fuck? What were you guys doing in there?
We were just smoking, just chilling, bumping music. And I...
You're all cracked out.
I was like cracked out. And I was like, damn, I got a dip. And I had to take 2 buses, a big one and a small one. So on the way back, I take the small one, then a big one. So on the small one, I get in, I pay the dude, sit down on this like long bench seat on the side of the bus because they have the benches all set up differently down there. And fucking, I'm just stretched out as like long as possible, and nobody else could sit on the bench. I felt fucked up, and at one point, I thought everybody was speaking English. I had music in my headphones, and I I kept hearing people having these in-depth, full conversations in English. So I took off my headphones and just everybody was silent. And like one person was talking.
That's sketchy as fuck. The hell is that?
And then by the big bus, I realized I was just fucked up. Like I was like, damn, this is like full realization point. I was just like, damn.
The crack fucking epiphany.
Yeah, I was like, I'm fucked up. This is not weed. This is like not chill. I could, yeah. I was afraid I was gonna get like lost.
Oh, like just end up on some cracked out mission.
Yeah.
Fuck.
So I just huddled in the back of the last bus and just like sweated out like crazy. And then by the time I got off, I was just like crouching like away, and then just like got to home all like hobbled out, just like felt like a fucking hunchback.
What did people say back at the house? Were they like, bro, you look all cracked out?
I just went straight to my room.
Yeah, done.
Right when I opened the door, it's like right to the left of there.
Not doing nothing. Yeah, it's over.
Yeah,
day done.
And then the next day, yeah, that's when they were like, we just fucking do that shit, dog.
Oh, that shit's sick, fool.
Yeah, like, we mix it up with meth.
What the hell?
We mix it up with fucking, I don't know what else, like oxy and shit, like other shit.
What in the world?
They be mixing it up with
oxy, wouldn't that's like more Coke. Expensive.
Well, they got like pills that are the same components, but they're just like bootleg, yeah, like Xans and shit. They got like the bootleg Xan kind of shit.
Oh, Xanos.
Yeah, exactly.
Some Xanos. Some
like yellow fucking Xans.
Oh my god, sounds fucking scary, bro. Yeah. It's just weird that you can just like get some random shit that'll just have you just zonked.
Super zonked.
Fuck, just like a fake just chemical contraption. Dude, you just swallow and you just zonked. So sketch.
It's not even the same as like what you get from the other shit.
It's just, no, like, it's just some fake, random yeah. shit. Yeah, like kind of like those, like when the bath salt shit was going down. Like it's just like, I think all that's just like fake coke, like, or fake crack or something.
Yeah, synthetic.
Yeah,
like how there's a 2CB.
Like you just sniff some shit that was never supposed to touch your body, and then you just turn into fucking Zonko. Done. So gnarly.
Synthetic PCP.
It's just weird. I saw this fucking Booyah sent me this video the other day, and this fool runs up on this dude in this car that crashed, and he's like, yo, what are you doing, da da da. And the dude gets out of the car and he's like, blah blah blah, and he's all chill, and he's like, yeah, you just crashed your car. And then the dude just pulls out a fucking can of dust off and just starts doing whippets.
Whoa. That's definitely what that dust off shit does.
And he's just like all chill and like happy, and then he just sits back down in the car and is just like laughing and like taking the whippet, like even though he doesn't even have any more fucking breath, he's like just trying to like suck out as much as he can. Yo. So gnarly. And he's a security guard randomly.
The dude that's all fucked up?
Yeah, the dude that crashed the car. Shit. He's like, yeah, you crashed your car, and then like, I don't know. By the end of the video, the dude realizes that the dude's all fucked up, and he's just like, what the fuck is this guy doing right now? Yo. It's so bad, bro.
Yeah, there's so many videos of people driving or just on motorcycles and shit, just like doing fucked shit. But that's crazy. I feel like that's like probably a mixture of drugs right there. Maybe he was like faded and off some like uppers, and then just hitting the dust off to no top idea. It off.
No idea. I don't know how you could be that brain gone. Shit's insanity. Dude. Like sometimes I'll be like thinking about like shit I've done in the past, and I'm just like, damn, dude, I wonder if I maybe messed up my brain. And then you see some shit like that, you're like, yeah, no, good,
yeah, good to I'm go. I'm pretty good.
I'm G2G for sure. Yeah. Literally nothing in my body would be okay with that situation.
If anything, we're more advanced from it.
Yeah, dude, I'm smarter off the drug that I did, for sure.
It's not like a smartness, it's more of a realization type shit. Not trying to be on our high and mighty, fucking like, yeah, we fucking trip balls, dude, and fucking it's unlocked nice, a higher level.
It's just nice to know where you don't want to be, like yeah, where specifically you, to know, instead yeah. of it being up in the air.
It's good to know where you lie with things, for sure. Within everything. Instead of just being like, I am this.
For sure.
it helps to like be like, oh shit, I'm this.
You gotta fuck around sometimes, dude.
Yeah.
You gotta like
humble.
It's yeah, humbling. Exactly. You gotta realize it's a lot more going on than
the mushies.
What you got going on, yeah, for sure.
The mushies are humbling, for sure.
Mushies not even drugs anymore.
It's just the root of wherever our consciousness comes from type shit.
Actually, I take that back, dude. Feeding enough mushies, that's definitely drugs for sure. But
yeah.
I always forget that I eat, like, bitch amounts of mushies.
Yeah.
Like, the most bitch.
It's a good one, though.
Shit's cozy, bruh.
Yeah, you don't want to be, like, fucking sweating in the corner.
I'm not going to run outside off 2 grams of mushrooms, bro. I'm sorry. It's $2. I'll just end up at my house in blanket listening to fucking music.
Yeah. Candles lit.
But a little micro, a little point two, G2G, my boy.
Yeah. Snapping. That's when you're ready for shit. You can go wherever and so you kind of just acclimate to whatever situation
you're on. For sure. It's a lot less like chatter in your brain off that shit. It's crazy.
Yeah.
That schizoid fucking crack vibe, bro. Just hearing people converse in your head. Yeah, sketch.
That's something that I wasn't expecting at all, for sure.
That shit's really sus. It's also weird too, like all that shit's, I think like all that shit's constantly going on in your head. It's just like that certain drug will just get you into that zone, like some weird zone of your brain that doesn't make sense.
A part of me, yeah.
Super sketch.
Part of me really needing to smoke weed was because of I just get these crazy ass dreams when I don't smoke weed, and I'll wake up and I'm like, fuck, thank God.
Yeah, the no weed dreams are no fucking joke. Sometimes I'll get bummed, like, oh, I smoke too much fucking weed and just pass out. I don't even have dreams anymore. But when I do have a dream, I'm like, get me out of here, bro.
Yeah.
It's so gnarly. Even if it's not like scary, it's just like way too vivid and just in my face. I'm like, dude, this is fucking, or it's like 15 hours long and I'm just stuck in this fucking world. It's fucking $2.
Yeah, the dream world is a scary one for sure. It can be most of the time because it's just so spontaneous, and however your subconscious is reacting to everything is how it's gonna like morph into. So you just kind of want to like always keep it clear.
That shit's like realer than fucking real life. It's way too gnar. Because like in real life, you see shit going on all the time, but like it's kind of an option as to whether or not you're going to interact with it. But in the dream, like whatever you look at, it just starts happening. You're like, oh shit, here we go. Like,
yeah,
I don't know. I always get like, I try to like try to lucid dream and shit because I always get sleep paralysis. But every single time, bro, I see some shit starts popping up. And I'm like, all right, just be cool with this. Just be cool with this. And then it turns into some weird shit. And I'm like, I'm not cool with that. And then it just throws me into some sort of vortex. And I always have to try to flip myself over. It's fucked.
Damn.
But most of the time, I just pass out blackness.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Wake up. Eyes are open. That's it.
Pretty dank, though.
Yeah. Feel rested?
Super rested, yeah. I sleep like baby. I always look tired, though. I wonder if that... I swear that's fucking stomach parasites. Pretty sketch. Oh. Gotta figure that one out.
There's, like, some sort of juice. Some, like, holistic juice you can drink.
I was thinking to get a juicer.
Yeah.
I was thinking about that. Just
take shots of, like, celery. Anti-parasitic, yeah.
Celery and fucking parsley and shit.
Yeah. Put a lime in there.
Beat G2G out that, seriously.
Yeah. Make your own juices.
Fuck. Yeah.
Jar them. Put them in the refrigerator.
I always want to be like a blender juicer guy, but I don't know, too lazy. It's
pretty time consuming. Yeah. You gotta sit there for like an hour prepping everything, and then you fucking... I mean, depending on how much juice you're trying to make.
Fuck, not that much. An hour?
Yeah, I was thinking about like prepping a bunch of like fruit and like veggies and shit.
Just throw it into a blender.
Some roots. Oh, and like just sift it with like one of those little screens and shit. You use one of those little bulb screen things.
Yeah, I don't know. Gotta figure something out.
Yeah.
Not sure what it is. But I can tell something's going strange in there for sure.
You can get this anti-parasitic shot. It's like not a shot, like it's just like a little liquid shot. That's what I mean.
You drink it and you shit all day.
Oh,
you just
my
want to be at
God.
Home all day.
Dude, that's not... I'm
I
not
mean,
into
just
that.
Shit that out.
Jesus.
But then you're good, dude.
Yeah.
Clears you out.
Dude, what the hell? All right, enough of that, dude. What the hell? So sketch. It's
yeah.
good, dude.
My uncle and aunt in Mexico would hit that shit.
Yeah. Dude, one time I was sick up north, and this fucking Spanish chick told me that when she would get sick back home, her fucking mom would give her bleach, and she would drink bleach. And I was like, what the fuck? I don't know if she was trying to kill me or what. Super weird.
Yo.
I was like, you want me to fucking drink bleach? Yeah. Yeah. Your goddamn mind?
Yeah, no, some weird,
should have
weird
fucking
thinking.
Should have squeezed
dude.
The shit out of her nose.
Yeah, I knew this chick. She would squeeze lime in her ear
oh
and
my.
In her nose.
What the fuck?
She would
is
have
that?
An ear infection, and she'd squeeze a lime, just irritate it more. I was like, yo,
ooh,
that's not good.
Oh my God, that's fucked up. A lime?
A lime.
That's weird. That's like some chemical like efficiency shit. Like that's such like a instinctual decision.
Yeah.
That's like a kid eating dirt. You know what I mean? Like
yeah.
when kids eat dirt, supposedly it's like because. They know on an animal level that they need certain minerals and shit.
Dude.
Or maybe they're just tripping balls, who knows? I remember when someone first told me, like, oh, look at these mint leaves, and I started, like, looking for mint leaves and shit. Like, little, you know how you sometimes you see wild mint?
Uh-huh.
And I would, like, eat the mint leaves and shit, and then I started eating other leaves, and they all sucked for sure. Shit's ash.
There is this one plant that's like this long strand of grass. It's like lime. It tastes like lime.
Crabgrass?
Like
sweet grass?
It's kind of like sweet grass. I think so. Just kind of chew on it.
Yeah, fuck all that.
Some sort of property to it.
Now I enjoy snacks. Fuck, I forgot to time this fucking thing. God damn it. Son of a bitch. How deep into this do you think we are? Probably like 3 minutes.
Huh, we're just 10 minutes?
Yeah.
Just to say 10.
Yeah. Fuck it, though. Bah. Yeah, man.
Yeah, dude. So I had this dream that I was in my crib with my family. And
recently?
There was just a murderer outside.
Recently?
Yeah, it was like a Jason Voorhees type, like Michael Myers figure.
I have those dreams too, bro.
Where I like can't leave.
Uh-huh.
And I'm stuck with a couple of people.
And you just have the constant thought of like, all right, this is about to go down, but I'm not
yeah,
sure how it's
not sure
happen.
When it's going to
yeah.
go down.
Uh-huh.
And I just know this figure is, like, very, very strong.
Somewhere nearby.
Yeah.
Like, you see a quick little glimpse of it, and you're like, wait,
yeah.
And then you go back, and you, like, kind of feel safe for a second, but you know it's still sketch.
And I'm just having these, like, heartfelt conversations with my family.
Because you
and
know,
then
like,
I'll just
someone's
see
about to
or
die.
Hear some shit. Yeah.
Fuck.
Just, like, a mix of shit. And then it just made me think that that's what life is. Just, like, you're always, like, in this battle. Of, like, not knowing what's about to happen, and then you're just with the people that you, like, care about in your circle.
Yeah.
That's, like, the house that you make.
Just slow, like, silently just panicking about death.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, death's always outside the door.
I was thinking about this fucking, what happened at the end of the dream?
I just woke up, I think, I just was in the house the whole dream. Nothing happened. Nobody died. But then there was, like, another dream that kind of ties into that, and it was, like, a demon kind of possession shit.
After?
That was before.
What the
so hell? I had, like, a series of dreams, but all spaced out.
Sketch, bro. Maybe you were the murderer in the dream. Bah.
Nah.
I'm just kidding.
It was definitely not me.
Sketch.
It was just, like, some weird, like, shadowy kind of figure.
So fucking weird, bro.
Just, like, essentially a figure made of shadows.
Shit's not chill.
It's morphing and shit.
I was thinking this morning about this dream I had, and I don't know, it's like one of the main dreams I fucking remember. Shit was so long ago, but it was like I was just thinking about this one part, and I was wondering if I should try to draw it, but it's just so much like details in it. It's just weird. But it was at the end of this like long ass dream I was having, but I was standing at this like desert fucking oasis, like. Imagine if there was, like, a cliffside in the shape of, like, a half circle.
Uh-huh.
And it's, like, a cliffside that you can barely fit onto. And there's, like, a super big drop. And then at the bottom of the drop, there's, like, a big-ass pool of water. like a desert oasis, bro. Crazy. So weird. And fucking, I was just standing there, like, with my back against the wall of this cliffside, like, looking down on this fucking desert oasis, and I see all these people and shit in this circle, and, like, this fucking, you know, the little face hugger thing from fucking Prometheus?
Yeah.
That shit just pops out of the fucking, out of the water, and just jumps up straight to my face, and just starts crawling all over my face, like, all gnarly. And then the fucking, I don't remember what they call them in Prometheus, like, they call them the architects or some shit?
Uh-huh.
Like, the main dudes that, in the beginning, like, the fucking alien guy.
Yeah.
Like, that fool pops out of the fucking desert oasis, jumps up, and grabs the alien off my face, and then just goes back into the fucking pool of water and just, like, dies on some gnarly shit. And then the whole, like, scene kind of just collapses, and then I went and did some other shit after. But I always remember that shit. It's so fucking weird, bro. It's like some weird, like, Jesus-type vibe going on there, I swear, bro. Or, like, I don't know, Prometheus, the movie's kind of, like, about some god shit.
Yeah, but early, like, early god.
Or whoever's made all this shit happen.
Yeah.
But it was fucking weird, bro. Way too much. I don't really even care about that movie that much to have a fucking dream about it. Right. You know what I mean?
Just how depictive the lore is in that movie, it's definitely something that can produce something, like some sort of like brain capsule.
The very opening scene of that shit is like one of the most fired scenes ever, I feel like.
Yeah.
Shit's so like just outer worldly and just gnar.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know, it's so fucking weird. Like, it's he just, fire. like, I don't remember exactly what it is. He, like, coughs some shit out of his mouth or some weird shit. And then he, like, turns black and this fool just, like, dies on some gnarly shit.
Yeah, it's, like, DNA gets intertwined with the, with the Earth.
And gnarly. That's how
we become ourselves. Like, we're just, like, a descendant of this dude just dying and letting his DNA just propagate or whatever.
Right, that's like some Jesus shit, I feel like. Maybe in a sense, I don't know. But yeah, that shit's gnarly, straight up, bro.
Jesus, huh? He's like the ancestor of Jesus.
I swear that's like the main dream of my fucking life. It's like the main one that I think back and like, that dream was Buck. I can barely remember other ones I had.
Damn. There was that one where I was a kid and I died. Or no. So I was myself and then I died and then I became this other kid with like a mom and a little brother. And I remember them.
Oh yeah, I think you told knew me
their
that.
Names and shit.
That shit's sketch, bro.
Like, that shit's crazy.
Like, is like that shit, I don't know what that is. Like, is I don't know. It's some weird, bro.
Yeah, they're all just, like, these symbolic metaphors. Like, every dream you have is just, like, a symbolic metaphor and shit.
It's just, like, where are you? Shit. Like, where are you at when that shit's going down? It's so fucking weird.
Just, like, I guess it's probably, like, a plane that's always been there, and our brain could tap into it when the... We're in that situation when our brain's, like, in that mode.
Right.
But who knows?
And it's like that plane's going on, though, when you're not sleeping. Shit's gnarly.
Yeah. People encounter those reoccurring figures in their dreams. Like, have you seen this person? And it's just, like, a dude's face that you see, like, multiple people have seen.
When I saw that picture, I had a dream about that dude, and I was sketched the fuck out. So fucking sketch, bro. Not chill.
What is that?
I think something about the image is just like very maybe super impressionable on people's brains, like I don't know.
Yeah. Maybe subconsciously, like, it just can hook you in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't fuck with that image, bro.
Weird.
I had the dream like almost immediately after and I was like, oh hell no, here's this fool right here. So sketch. Just immediately see him. Shit is burnt.
Yeah.
After that, I was like, fuck that thing. Fuck is that?
Yeah, there's the dream realm people. Maybe they're just stuck in the dream realm, or...
Yeah, I don't know.
Who knows?
I feel... I don't know what it is, or I feel like I'm so spaced out that I'm fucking... Like, I'm so locked in my dreams that they're maybe... Because I feel like I don't remember them, but I swear they're just, like, turning into, like, memories or some shit.
Crazy.
And I'm just like, yup. But it's just like a dream. It's weird. I swear a lot of the dreams, if I'm not too conscious of them too, they're always so mundane. It's like me doing nothing.
Yeah.
Dude, the other day at my fucking work, I was like so stoned out. Like, it was like end of the day type shit. At like 4 o'clock p.m., we'll take a break and smoke weed and shit. And I went back inside and I was just so just end of the day out. And I was like kind of doing this super repetitive task. And I was starting to, like, doze off, but I kept going. And fucking, I was looking at these little vape things that we were packing up. And I was seeing them like blue, bro. Shit you not. I was like, what the fuck? These things are fucking blue. Kind of, it's weird. And I, as I was pulling out the tubes and shit, I kept looking at them and I was like, this shit looks so fucking strange right now. Like, what is going on with these things? And I kept going, kept going. And then at some point, I like impulsively, like the he's kind of like our manager or whatever, the homie that tells us all the shit to do, is standing right next to me. And I just like impulsively, like kind of in a snap out of it moment, I'm like, hey, fucking, like really quickly, I'm like, hey, do you think the color on these things? And I like halfway through my sentence, I was like, what the fuck am I even saying? And I'm like looking at the thing. I was about to ask him, like, hey, do you think these things look blue? I was about to ask him that because I kept seeing this blue shit, bro. And then I'm like, as I'm asking him that, I look at the fucking thing. It's just not blue at all. It's just a regular fucking, like, fucking hallucinating and shit, bro. It was gnarly. And after that, I felt so fucking weird. I was like, what's going on here, bro?
That's some Scanner Darkly shit.
For real, bro. That shit was weird.
That's some straight up Danner Barkley.
I was straight up moving in like a fucking half sleep state, like just stickering these fucking tubes. It was weird, bro.
Yeah.
And then like, I don't know, it was just like in the middle of my sentence, I was like, what am I talking about? And then I like look at the thing and it just clearly wasn't blue. And then I was like, the dude's looking at me like, what are you trying to say? Because I, like, kind of just mumbled this, like, half sentence. And then I was like, I was about to ask you about the color of these things, but never mind. Like,
yeah.
And I just felt weird as fuck after that. I was like, what the fuck is going on here, bro? Hallucinating.
Yeah, it is some Danner Darkly.
Straight hallucinating. Half sleep, bro. It was gnarly.
I'd be kind of getting the same thing, but it's just these little lights that'll, like, spurt out.
Sketch.
Kind of, they're like, it's like, you know how you see dust particles sometimes, like squiggly lines of shit.
Yeah.
Instead it'll be like balls of light, so they're just tiny little like floating fragments of light that have slight traces to them.
Fuck.
And then they have also like a deep black outer lining, but they're bright, so they're just moving.
Boy, what the fuck? So, that's that crack fucking after effect.
But yeah. I kind of been getting that my whole life.
What the
hell? I feel like I've been seeing that shit for a while now.
Yeah. Yeah, shit weird, bro.
Be
tripping in fucking regular life.
Yeah.
I was telling you about those fucking brain zaps I've been getting. That shit is weird, too. Like, lay down and, like, hear, like, it sounds, it's a super loud vibration in my ears, and it gets so loud that I like open my eyes, and then it's like I'll be so zonked out that it's like hard for me to sit up, and I'm like, whoa, what
maybe
the fuck?
It's the fucking government rays, bro.
Yeah. Or so like I looked online real quick and someone said a common one is too much caffeine, and I was like, whoa. I believe the fuck out of that. Yeah. But at the same time, it's just weird. I don't know.
Yeah,
never felt that shit. It's super weird. And then there was a couple of days where I was feeling it kind of a lot, even like in the middle of the day and shit. And then today I'm not really feeling it so much.
Yeah.
No fucking brain zaps.
No zaps of the brain.
Shit was weird. I felt like I was getting my fucking brain zapped, bro. That's pretty sketch. That is some government fucking interference, bro.
Dude.
The hell.
Who knows?
I've also just been bombarding my brain with Bluetooth for the past, like, fucking 10 months. Just every single day is just, like, 75% of my day is just me Bluetooth and straight into my brain.
Yeah, I prefer the wired headphones.
Right.
Because I think I was using some Bluetooth and I would get, like, little earaches.
Super sketch. That shit is manufactured.
So then I just get the wired shit because wired is just...
Right.
But then you had to think about, like, certain hearing, like, build-up shit. Like, over just, like, hearing intense bass and treble direct in your ear.
Straight to your fucking brain.
Yeah. You get hearing loss definitely over time.
For real. I guess, too, like, it's not even about how loud you're listening to music, but if you're listening to it for a long time with headphones, that shit just rocks your shit.
Yeah. Also, the arch right here. The top arch on headphones, that shit can, it dents your head.
So fucking burnt.
Use a little marker.
Right? When I put mine on the top of my hat, if I have it on top of the little ball that's at the top of the hat, that shit hurts, bro.
Yeah.
It's probably digging a hole into my fucking head.
Yeah. It's for the Neuralink, dude.
For real, what the fuck? burnt.
That's been the plot, dude.
Oh, maybe that's why I'm getting these brain zaps.
Jesus Christ. Oh, they're trying to link in without the Neuralink in your brain. They're just trying to figure out if they can just link in.
Holy.
I wonder if they could do that. Like, once they put the tech in the brain, they're like, oh, that's how you tap in this way. You know?
For sure. They're working on that for sure.
Like how they got the wireless internet. Like, right before on. You hadn't had to have the wire, but now you just, like...
Fuck. It's wireless, yeah. I was thinking about that, too, with the fucking... Like, the, for sure, Bluetooth is, like, a long-term plan type shit. You know what I mean? And, like, why would Apple make a phone with no headphone jack?
They say the Bluetooth symbol is, like, a archaic, like, pagan symbol, too.
Jesus.
But that could just be some fucking...
Yeah, that's, like, probably some looking too deep into it shit.
Yeah.
Who the fuck knows? It's kind of like the... they say, like, the monster thing is, like, 666, but then at the same time, it's, like... Alright, monster. Like,
right.
Is monster doing some evil shit? I wonder.
Yeah, there's a lot of companies that have, like, the pagan shit. There's this video of LeBron James throwing up all these, like, sacred symbols. <I've seen
that. laughs> Yeah, all that shit, I don't know. I'm pretty good on all that, like, nowadays.
Like, back, it's like, to back.
Yeah.
Yeah, try to... It just finds me.
Yeah, for
nowadays,
sure.
I just scroll and I'm like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
There's just so much proof of it. I have these dreams as well. When it's like I'm on some Jason Bourne shit. Like, I'm just being chased the whole dream. And I have to, like, take fools out and just, like, keep going. And, like,
that's buck, bro.
I see, like, somebody I fuck with and they, like, get got or, like, they turn on me.
Yeah, that's the worst fucking in the dream.
I just
gotta keep moving.
I'm just like, fuck. And then I wake up and I'm like, fuck, I was on the run the whole dream. Like, thank God.
Exhausted.
Thank God.
Exhausted when you wake up. Yeah, yeah, fuck. Yeah, no weed dreams are fucked up, dude.
Yeah, seriously. Smoke some weed.
Tiring ass dreams, bro. Running around. Can't even really remember the last dream I had. Been a while, bro.
Yeah. Yeah, that last one, though, where I was in the house for sure, that was the one that stuck out.
Sketchy.
Yeah.
Holy fucking macro brand.
Fucking A, dude. American dream, though, dude.
American dreamers over here.
Oh, just some American dreamers.
Sleepy
dreamers.
Happens, dude.
Been drinking a lot of coffee, too.
Right, I've been drinking a lot of coffee and not enough water. Shit's bad, bro.
Yeah, I gotta get a fucking gallon, bro. I feel like I'm just, like... You know how, like, they say you're 70% water? I feel like I'm 70% coffee right now. Shit's sketch.
Right. Shit's burnt. I always, like, yeah. I think about how what percentage of fucking parasite in your body is, like, the top level to which you can function. Like, you're just, like, 30% parasite, and you're just like, yep, I'm pretty sure I'm killing it. Fuck.
Dude.
So gnarly.
Yeah. There's, like, so many layers to it and shit, too. Fucking
too much, dude. Way
gotta
too
watch
much.
Out for that fucking mercury, bro.
Yeah.
Can't eat too much fish.
Supposedly the sardines are good because they're real small, so they eat small, clean stuff.
Uh-huh.
Lots of algae or some shit.
That's fire.
Yeah, and it's the most, like, prisoned out fucking fish of all time.
God, poor things, dude.
No, I mean, like, fools in prison love sardines.
Oh, shit.
It's like some jail food shit. I didn't even know that, but at some point I was macking sardines. So gross.
Uh-huh.
It's gnarly. There's some shit I'd do up north that I would try to run back when I was down here, and I was like, this is not the vibe at all.
Yeah, it's just different when you're up there, because just having some, like, package, small.
Protein supplement,
and just...
I would just crack it. Get all the oil out of there and just throw hot sauce and then just destroy it in like 30 seconds. Just throw the can fucking indiscriminately into the woods.
No.
Savage. I'll never do that again over here. Maybe if I was up there long enough, but yeah, fuck. Shit's brew. I would try to eat it down here and I'd be like, dude, this shit tastes so fishy. It was fucked.
Oh, you've had like decent meals and then...
Literally, not even trying to be funny, it's just straight up smells like dirty snatch. It's gnarly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, the just textbook definition scent of it. If you open a can of sardines, just take a fat whiff, and that's exactly what it is.
Dude.
Or it's more of a smell that you catch while you're chewing it. Like, while you're chewing, like...
Yeah, and then your breath just smells like dirty snatch.
Ooh. Yeah, you gotta walk around like that.
Gotta walk around with the dirty so breath buck. Snatch fucking
it's stink. That's a gnarly essence to walk around with.
Dude.
Coming out of your mouth.
It's so a pH buck. Balance thing, dude.
Supposedly, it's supposedly that scent is bacterial vaginosis.
Oh.
Ooh. It's a harsh term, but it's out there. The pH probably leads to the bacterial vaginosis.
Gotta stay strapped out here, boys.
Your sketch. Yeah, fools like you, bro. Mobbing around fucking 18 days no shower.
No.
55 days no fucking scrub.
Aw, dude.
And fucking 90,000 days no butt wipe.
Oh, dude. Yeah, dude.
That's you, dude.
No, dude. That's the article. Just kidding.
Fucking crying. I can't even tell what we're talking about on this one. I don't know what's going on.
We were talking about dreams, and then we're on
all we've talked about is dreams and shit.
Vaginosis.
Yeah, that's what we got. Fuck.
No, it's chilled, bro. Getting back in the reins, dude. You know, you gotta fucking acclimate back in. You've been working on your truck back fucking marathon.
Izo's been working on my truck. I've been passing him fucking tools from time to time. But yeah, shit's going. It's going again. I can drive.
Shit looks sick.
Yeah.
Fucking killed it, dang. Shout out Izo.
Hoping everything goes according to plan.
New seats are hard.
The new seat is the best part. Fuck, dude. When I was driving in it, I, like, remembered that the seat was dank, and I just, like, laid back and just, I don't know, it was so comfortable. I was like, what the hell? Insane. These seats I had before in my truck were so shitty. You would sit in the seat and, like, sink into it.
Jesus.
It's gnarly. Super fucked up. There was, like, when I was driving to work every day, I thought my back started hurting so fucking bad, like my lower back, and I thought it was because I sat at work all day, but now that I've been sitting in a different seat, it's like my back doesn't hurt at all. It was straight up just that shitty, fucked up seat.
Gotta have that arch support, back arch support shit.
Yeah, I don't know. It's a pretty old, basic seat, but it's so comfortable somehow. It's so dang.
Broken into.
It's bomb as fuck. It's insanity.
It's all... Yeah, shit's hard.
Yep.
Shit's hard.
Hoping everything's good to go. There's still a couple little things where I'm like wondering what's going on, but I think it might just be because everything, it's a brand new head, so it might just take some time to break in and stuff.
Yeah.
I had a blown head gasket on my fucking truck. Crazy. People, and shit was gnarly.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're back at it, dude.
Shit's buck.
Fucking A. Pretty hyped though. Got a new front bumper on that shit. New back bumper and some dank ass rims, dude. I've been spending shit tons of money though. I'm kind of fucking. I gotta chill out for a little bit. Spent so much fucking money in May and June. It's insanity.
Yeah.
Seriously, insanity.
Investments.
Yeah, so.
That's right though.
It is what it is.
Staying busy, dude. Gotta stay busy.
It's better to spend it on some shit that's, like, cool instead of just, like, burritos and fucking...
Yeah, something worth it. It has some longevity to it.
Yeah.
I usually be buying, like, tech gear shit.
Yeah, exactly. Shit like that, too.
Or shit for my bike.
Anything that just goes afterwards. Yeah. Not just, like, a one-and-done fucking spending frenzy. I spend so much fucking money on dumb shit. It's insane, bro.
Yeah. I'll go on, like, food sprees and shit.
Yeah.
Just, like, eat as much as I can in one day and then just, like, be dust the next day.
Right. I'll just always think, like I don't do too much. Like, where's all this money going? I'll look at the fucking... You can look on your bank app or whatever. It shows all your transactions, and I'm just like, oh, my God. It's like some crackhead tendencies, bro. Just impulsively spending on nothing. Multiple times a day is gnar.
Yeah.
And there's, like, always easy ways out of that shit. Like, I don't know. I don't know. Some stuff is just like
just being mindful. Danker. Like, yeah.
But yeah, it's about being mindful for sure. I just get in the habit of like where I'm spending shit at, and I'm like, yep, going there again. Yep, yep, yep. And it's just like, I don't even think about whether I have to or not. It's more just about like time of day, what I'm about to do. Like, yeah, definitely gonna hit that. I don't know. Right. Some dumb, straight up fucking victim of capitalism bullshit, bro.
Yeah, just capitalism, impulsive spending. But it's also pretty fucking dope, dude.
I mean, it's better than the alternative, bro, for sure. But
it's better than the Russian fucking...
It's better to work it than to fucking let it work you, for sure.
Yeah. It's better than that Adam Curtis.
For a second, I was fucking stacking my cheese. My truck sucked the life out of that little stint, but I'm trying to get back on it. Go rice and beans for a quick little second.
That's right.
The bean rice and cheese burrito, bro. I always think, like, I'm gonna not, when I'm making it, I'm always like, fuck, dude, I'm like a straight up animal. All I eat is bean rice and cheese burritos. But then when I start eating it, I'm like, damn, this is the fucking best shit ever.
Yeah.
So dank. I'm always like kind of bummed while I'm making it, and then I end up eating two.
Yeah, you can't go wrong with that shit.
And it's so fucking cheap. This shit's dirt. If you ate that for a month, your ass would be rich.
Yeah.
And all you had to suffer through was bean rice and cheese burritos, one of the best fucking meals on the planet.
I just be thinking too much about what I'm gonna eat instead of just being like, this is what I should eat.
Yes, I feel you on that. Yeah, I've been eating like I was thinking too, the little brain zaps I've been getting, it might be because I've been eating cheeseburgers and shit for like cheeseburgers and pizza for the past like fucking 2 months. Gluten, pretty gnarly.
Gluten, like bread, eating excess amounts of bread. Just
high cholesterol, a lot of grease, a lot of bread, all that, bro. Chipotle sauce, bacon.
Yeah.
Fucking pizza, pepperoni.
Yeah.
It's a fucking miracle my heart even exists. Smoking cigs, smoking so many spliffs at work. Gnarly, bro.
Yeah. No, I think I'm gonna get a rice cooker for work. Start making rice at work.
Right, get on some sort of shit like that, huh?
Yeah.
That is beast.
Yeah.
Yeah, the one thing that keeps me from bringing food to work is, like, I need to eat my shit, like, straight out of the skillet or else it's over.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, I'd rather just cook it there. Yeah. Shit, make some fresh rice.
Something like that, huh? Like,
some beans on the side, too. Right. Literally just start doing the bean, rice, cheese.
Another reason I don't fucking bring food to work is because I don't want to eat out of the microwave.
Yeah. Oh.
Good on that. God damn it.
They don't got a little kitchen set up. It's just microwave.
Just microwave. They have like a toaster oven type situation, but yeah, no. If they had a stove, the shit would be foul as fuck. But yeah,
Just be the only one cleaning it? Shit.
Fuck. I love going to the spots that we go to, but I spend money like fucking straight up moron.
Just gotta eat that fucking... Yeah, everything's gonna cost a good amount there, though, too.
They won't let you leave the building without spending $15. Fuck. If you're gonna tip and be cool with the people that you're seeing every day.
Yeah.
I go to these fucking Arabian dudes, they check up the cheeseburgers and stuff, dude.
Ooh.
Always gotta give them the fat tip, because they're the broskies, but this full booyah is funny as fuck. He like... He's the homie that brings his own lunch, and fucking one of the chefs at the spot that we go to, I was like, damn, this homie has a fucking Tesla. And fucking Booyah was like, yeah, no shit, homie, you fucking paid for it.
Oh, fuck.
So smoked out. Definitely not, though. I haven't spent fucking like 70 grand at fucking at the burger spot.
Imagine you like check it all back.
Dude, when I was looking really at how much I spend every month, I was like, oh no. Made me dude, I got pretty spooked.
Yeah.
But it's just been an expensive couple months because of this car thing.
Fuck.
Just going here and there. Bought some shit I didn't need. Got some other shit. It's just like, fuck.
Yeah. I mean, there is that. I don't know. Yeah,
it is what it is.
The microwave shit's not really the one.
No, it's not.
It's not really the one.
I was thinking too, I was like, I might maybe start like trying to just munch fat in the morning and just try to like soldier it out. But I was like, that's fucking garbage. That middle of the day, you're going to need, like, some decent food. It's just life. Yeah. So I don't know what I'm going to do exactly.
Make, like, fucking salads or some shit. I don't know. Fuck. I don't know if you fuck with salads like that.
I don't, but I should. I was thinking that too. I haven't
eaten. Because it's something cold.
I'm so like.
Like that.
I haven't eaten fucking many fruits and veggies in like countless days.
Yeah.
The most I get is like a couple dates or some shit.
Something that, fuck. You want to like prep some like. You want to have like sweet potatoes or yams prepped, some chicken, and then just throw the salad in there and fucking have some like dressing on the side. Like in a bottle, so it's not all just like sitting there and all fuck. When you open it, it's just like,
yeah, I don't know.
Fucking
hash. Either way, I'm gonna have to microwave some shit.
Yeah.
Fuck. Fuck microwaves.
Or just make like a little fucking toaster oven, like Sandoz kind of thing, and just flip them open and just have them toast in there and you just turn them over or some shit. I don't know. Some foil. Put some foil down.
That could be sick.
Just make some little fucking,
dude,
like a foot long.
I'm trying to get on my sandwich shit for sure. I'm yeah. trying to get smart, dude.
Yeah.
The other day, yesterday, I came home, dude, and I pulled the grocery bag out of my truck, and I pull on the handle, and the shit just fell, and, like, fell on the ground, and then I got inside. I bought some jelly, because I was going to get on some peanut butter and jelly, like, in the morning shit.
Mm-hmm.
And I pull the jelly out of the bag, and the entire jelly just falls out of the bottom. Because it cracked when I fucking dropped the bag. It's like, god damn it, dude. Jelly gone.
Fuck.
Brand new fucking fresh strawberry preserved jelly, dude. Garbage.
Damn.
Cocksuckers gave me a weak bag.
Oh, weak jars.
Fuck, the lady called me out, too. I was like, fucking... I told myself, too, before I went to the grocery store, I was like, all right, just buy some shit that you're really going to eat, bro. Like, don't fucking end up wasting some shit. And then... I go to the front and the lady was like bagging my groceries. She's like, what the fuck, you got like all snacks? I was like, hey, yeah.
Oh, fuck, dude. No, dude.
Straight goofball grocery out. Fuck.
Yeah, prep some potatoes and some fucking.
Nah. Yeah.
Prep some fucking, I don't know, just prep, I guess. That's it.
Right, shit hard. It's gotta prep. Get disciplined, dude.
It's like an hour. That's what I mean with like the juicer shit. It's like, if you're really trying to like do it, you might as well do it.
Yeah, exactly.
You gotta like.
It's gonna not happen if it doesn't happen.
Yeah.
Yeah, shit's gnarly.
Shit's all work. You just work till you die, bro.
Straight the fuck up.
And then
up.
You just have these fucked up dreams.
Straight the fuck up.
This is just straight up torture, bro. What is this shit? Why is this so torturous?
For real.
It's like, I'm trying to sip this coffee, but I gotta pay fucking $5 for that. It's yeah. like half an hour.
Now. And your ass wasted like 15 hours like getting the coffee, so like now fuck. You're just like behind or whatever the fuck it is. Yeah. Shit's gnarly.
And you just always got to scheme up the next money move, for uh-huh. sure.
Yeah, shit's garbage. I was thinking, too, I was like, fuck, I've been spending so much money. I was like, I need some more money before this next check. Like, I don't need it with my life, but I was like, that would be nice. And I was like, right. I have to figure out a way to make more money. And I'm already have a job. I'm like, Jesus fucking criminy, this is garbage.
Yeah.
I was coming home with Nick one day, and fucking, he was like, fuck, I feel like a fucking robot, like, we're just driving home every day and just work the same thing every day. I'm like, yeah, bro. Like, if you don't, like, you have to fucking do so much shit to get more than just the basic, like, thing. You know yeah, what I mean? Yeah. It's like, it's fucking savage, bro.
It is a very savage time.
Like, it seems like some shit where you're like, well, I'm going to do, like, the stuff that I like and that makes me happy. But, like, the conscious effort of trying to get more than just, like, standard issue shit is fucked, bro.
Super fucked.
So gnarly. I don't know. Maybe for some people it's easy, but, like, I don't know. If you're just a normal person, it's, like, you gotta think of some other shit every yeah. time. It's fucking gnarly.
A lot of cats will, like, hit the boar.
Yeah, whatever it is.
Whatever. Yeah. Hobbies. Gotta stay busy, dude. Or else you could fucking go crazy and unleash the beast.
Yeah, exactly. Because your brain's gonna go.
Full on 666.
Yeah. If you don't go, then your brain's just going to go for you and do some other shit. You literally just have to, like... That's kind of why, like, all that juice shit is good, too. Because, like, as long as you're doing something good and...
Yeah, fucking it's all, like,
takes up your purpose. Time. Yeah. Yeah, it's like, fuck it, dude.
Prep.
Yeah, shit's gnar, discipline. For sure. It's easy to just get...
Find peace and harmony through discipline. Like some straight samurai poetry shit.
Yeah, straight up. Find peace and harmony through discipline.
Yeah.
Straight up.
That's some shit.
fucking hey, dude. If you don't get disciplined, fucking life's gonna hit you with some shit that's gonna have you like, oh. Shit's buck for sure.
Shit is hella buck.
But yeah.
I got this picture from the homie in Japan smoking bud in his crib, and that shit's hella illegal.
So sketch, bro. You better get that fool fucking persecuted.
I'll just show you this shit.
Alright. Sketch, bro. Fool's about to get locked up. Won't let him out, Japan.
That's the only thing. Like, I would want to go to Japan and smoke, but it should be hard.
Fuck that, bro. Fool's ain't gonna play around. I'll chop your fucking hand off.
Well, I'd get excommunicated from Japan.
For real. You saw that fucking... That chick got locked up in Russia for fucking weed.
Oof.
Gnar. I wonder if that was real.
That's crazy because they got like a bunch of shit going on down there, or up there, over there.
Japan or Russia?
Russia.
Just that whole zone? Yeah. Who the fuck knows? Yeah.
Like, why would you even... Why would that be a thing?
Why?
How would that be
and a how, thing? Like, is the basketball... No, you know what it was? Because we fucking traded some shit. Remember that? They're like, all right, we'll give you this chick back. Give us this homie.
Yeah.
It was some way gnarly fucking super gnarly ass, like, KGB homie.
Yeah.
And we got fucking WNBA shit. Yeah. Gnar, bro. Not to say that that chick should have stayed incarcerated, but Jesus Christ. It was definitely some operation shit. Super weird.
So I guess that Hunter Biden...
Just kidding.
That Hunter Biden shit was going on recently because of the submarine shit. Nobody knew about that shit.
I haven't even looked into the submarine thing, but just the fact that it's been so widespread, I'm like, dude.
Yeah. Clear. Nobody's talking about the Hunter Biden thing, though.
I don't even know. Jesus Christ.
Some, like, court appeal passed.
Right.
And, like, nobody's talking about that. Fucking.
Dude, the submarine disappeared, bro. Can you believe that? That shit completely disappeared. Shit's fried.
That shit's dust. Those people are either imploded or they lost oxygen and died. Which would honestly be your best bet if you wanted to die in that situation.
Some weird shit's going to come out about that shit.
But if you implode.
15 years when no one cares anymore.
Yeah, they'll find some shit. They'll just find some, like, bloated bodies or just puddle liquid.
I think it's probably just dust, yeah. At the bottom of the ocean.
Like some shrunken piece of metal, yeah.
I saw some fucking thing on Instagram today, and it was, like, supposedly, like, historic images, and I literally couldn't tell if it was, like, AI-generated or not.
Mm-hmm.
And I just got over it. I was like, this is... Who knows what this is?
Yeah.
That's where we're at now.
That's fucking... Yeah, no, weird, no information's real anymore.
I couldn't tell. Like, literally couldn't tell.
Those millionaires probably never got lost. They probably just wanted to fake their death, and then they just, like, went into another fucking spot, like, dipped out, and they're like, yeah, we haven't found it.
Some controlled op shit, man.
Yeah.
Super fried.
And
people they're
tied in with the Hunter Biden administration.
Yeah. Bro, like, they're willing to let people go for just to make some shit happen. Shit goes down, bro.
Shit's going down regardless if you want it or not.
Super weird. What's
super fucking weird.
But yeah, I don't know what that is.
Yeah, man.
Like, but it's just like, why? Like, why? I don't know. Why is a submarine thing, like, how's that international?
Right.
Among the international events going down?
Right.
The submarine that was looking for the Titanic? Some shit that happened in fucking 1930-something or some...
I think the only reason why it was so big is because people were just like, oh, these stupid-ass rich motherfuckers, dude.
Jesus Christ.
People meanwhile, there's fucking refugees dying off capsized ships.
Right.
Trying to go from... Fleeing from the Middle East.
Right.
Trying to go to Italy.
There's a lot of shit,
like,
going on.
Reinforce the borders. That's what they're saying. Instead of just letting them in.
Gnar.
They're fleeing... from being persecuted and murdered. And then other countries are like, we need to tighten this shit up. Fuck these people. It's fucked up, dude.
I mean, for sure,
but it is what it is.
Definitely, if you let, like, hella refugees into your town, shit's gonna go down, for sure.
Yeah.
You're either gonna have some, like, war shit going on with the locals, or, like, Because all those people are going to have nothing. They're going to have civil to end up unrest. Doing some hustle shit. Yeah, exactly. It's going to get buck, bro.
Then there's like a sense of hatred built within
for sure.
Like the refugees towards like the country that's taking them.
It's into. Some District 9 shit, bro. Yeah, it's fucking exactly. buck.
That's literally all it is.
It's fucked.
District 9.
Yeah, we're that's rocked.
A fire movie.
Huh. District 10.
Huh, they should do another fucking
district. I swear supposedly they're making District 10. Well, going back and watching that movie, though, I was like, damn, this shit's pretty... They're probably pretty low budge, relatively.
Yeah.
Well, relatively
like, low nowadays, budge. It'd probably be way easier in a way, like, knowing
oh, the yeah. We have way better CGI, for yeah. sure. Yeah, the CGI is pretty outdated even in that movie already. Pretty so crazy.
They have the Unreal 5 engine, I believe. But then there was also this engine that they used to play or create the Matrix, the new Matrix movie.
Yeah.
And it's just like a virtual demo. And there's just like, looks super realistic, bro. It's like disturbingly realistic.
Yeah.
So like nowadays, I'm sure it'd be way easier.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, everything's gnarlier now. They probably have, like, AIs that fill in lots of the more tedious gaps of all that shit.
All the animation shit.
Yeah. And then they have, like, all the foreground graphics, they probably customize themselves, and then they let the AI do, like, grass or whatever the fuck, you know right. what I mean? Like, just some quick shit. Shit's insanity, bro.
I've seen...
Can't even imagine. How the fuck you make a video game engine? Shit's ridiculous, bro.
Right.
Programmers shit's like damn near bigger than the actual planet. Like, what is that shit?
Right.
Shit's so weird. Fuck.
You can create a universe within the universe.
Yeah, shit's fried.
Fried.
Fucking A, mate. I was thinking about some shit. I was wondering, like, how the fuck do we know what galaxy we're in, but we don't know what's at the bottom of the ocean? How's that for a stoned out fucking question? Because the Earth is smaller than the whole galaxy, but you don't know what's the ocean?
Yeah, we can't scan it yet.
We don't even know what the ocean is, bro. Fuck, the maps are all fake, so like, I'm pretty sure if you go straight out in the ocean, I wonder if you could, fuck.
I think it just goes into relevance with like the amount of like pressure.
If all that shit's fake, how the fuck did fools ever travel by map?
Right.
Fools used to fucking... I guess you just get hella shit wrong. Well,
they would go by astral...
Whoa.
They would go by... They would chart the stars. Because the stars are the best map to use instead of like just like northeast and west and shit.
Yeah, but all that shit's faulty.
Yeah, because you want to like go in certain channels where the water is like the current flows a certain way. And that way you're not, like, going against the wind and, like, all that shit.
This fool Sticky the fucking... Sticky the Sailor, huh?
Yeah, I just know a little bit about it.
Let's hop on a boat, dude, so you can prove a little bit. Actually, just get lost at sea, die.
I got invited by the homegirl and her boyfriend to go out fishing because he fishes on, like, a tuna boat.
What the hell,
in
bro?
In Dago.
What kind of situation is that going to turn into?
Well, I mean, it's just like a fishing boat, you know?
All right, bro.
Like, there's, like, multiple fucking people there. It'd be, like, probably, like, 15 other people. They're all just fishing on the boat.
Yeah.
Just going out.
Sticky the Sailor.
I want to go spear fishing, but that shit's also really fucking scary.
The hell? Yeah, I'm good on that.
Catching a big-ass fish, but then there's, like, huge-ass sharks out there, so...
What the fuck? That's what you're trying to do?
At least once.
Yeah. That's gnar. Damn, I'm getting pretty hungry. Yeah. Did you eat anything?
I ate a banana with peanut butter.
I'm about to fight you. Where should we eat? Something delicious, huh?
Huh. Fucking hey.
Fuck.
I wonder if that new Cosmo Burger's open.
What the fuck? I'm good on that.
Right super across good from on the that. G?
No. Nope. Not eating that. What are you talking about, bro?
Because, I don't know.
No.
What the fuck?
You know what was pretty good was that Dave's hot chicken. The Ooh. Stuff was pretty good. It's better than Angry Schlong's.
It is way better. I'm hella down for that.
Fuck.
But it is in the mid.
It's over there. Yeah.
It's in the mid.
Yeah, oh, fucking A. We should probably try to sign out of here. I got Nathan.
It's in the mid of Osai.
Osai. Osai.
If you didn't know, this podcast is coming from Oceanside.
Yeah, he. All right, we're about to get out of here, people.
Sign us out, bro. All
right. I think I got a song. Here we go. Goodbye, everybody. Food time later. No more time for this bullshit. Ha, ha, ha.
Welcome to Milwaukee. Let that shit ring. Smack in time.